Good evening, everyone. I welcome you to today's lecture. My name is Dr. Abiola Olusegun. I'm a herbal medicine practitioner in MB Holistic Care. And what we are discussing today is about virus. It's about virus. Factors that makes us susceptible to virus, then the prevention of viruses. That's what we are quickly going to discuss now. You know, news everywhere about coronavirus makes it look like the worst disease ever in human history, with several recommendations on treatments and prevention. I'm not here to tell you what to do about it, how to do it. No. I'm purely going to share an information to you, so it is left to you to apply it if you find it useful, or just read it and ignore. When someone sneezes, it's about 20,000 droplets containing viruses and bacteria, depending on the health status of the person who sneezes. Depending on those things that are spread into the air, and that's the most mode of virus transportation to hosts, which is humans or animals. So viruses does not have wings to fly. They have to be propelled into the air, and someone has to get in contact with them, either through inhalation or droplets on ATM or door handles or handrails and so on, or on the skin directly. And all harmful viruses as targets, tissue targets, that's their targets. They target our tissues. Coronavirus targets lung tissues. And the Latin word for virus means poison. So let's say virus is poison. Viruses are everywhere. Some are in our system, but they are in dormant form. Something will definitely trigger them or activate them. If not, they won't harm us. 1 liter of seawater contains about 100 billion viruses. But why don't we get viral infections every time? It's because we can only get infected by them if we are susceptible to them. In fact, immediately viruses enter into our system, they have to quickly enter into our cells. And immediately they enter into the cells, they enter into and copy our cells, wrap themselves with our healthy cells layer, which is the entrance tissue. Then they will now come out and start spreading. So in that sense, it takes only very active immune system to identify them and attack. If not, to low immunity, they look like our healthy cells. So they won't attack. If your immunity is low, to your immune system, they will look like the normal cells, the healthy cells. So the immune system will not attack. But when you have a strong immune system, it will attack. Now, viruses cannot do anything without a host, which is you. Some die without a host within some hours, and some last more depending on temperatures. They are very, very small in size, unlike bacteria. And like I said earlier, they go through 5 stages in humans before causing harm. 1, they attach. I told us that they attach themselves to our cell walls. So they attach to our healthy cells walls. The responsibility of our white blood cell, which is the component of our immune system, is to attack them and kill them. But if our immunity is low, such won't happen. It won't attack them. So they will perform to the second stage, which is penetrating our healthy cells, because they have to hide from white blood cells. So they steal our cells' envelope, wrap themselves in heat. And the third stage for them is they replicate. The fourth is they assemble. Let's say, for example, MP3 disc, you know, songs are on it, but without a player, MP3 player, you can't listen to the songs on it. It's same with viruses. They enter into our healthy cells and replicate. They copy their functions, copy ourselves duplicator, because our elder cells duplicate themselves. So they copy our cells duplicator. With that, they can duplicate themselves and multiply in our system. And the fifth stage is that they will be released, then they will look like our elder cells. So it will take a very active immune system to recognize them. Some of us have viruses in our system and they get activated with opportunity. So there are some things that activate the viruses in our system. Age activate them, low immunity activate them, nutritional deficiency activate them, chronic disease activate them, stress activate them. So we need to manage our stress. We need to manage our lifestyles, watch our lifestyles and diets. If we have any chronic disease, we need to find something to do to it on time. You need to check yourself regularly to know if you have any ailment. Because if you have those, that means you'll be susceptible to virus. So low immunity, you have to boost your immune system and make sure that you are eating healthy, not just eating well. So nutritional deficiency is part of what activates them, and make sure you manage your stress. And now to susceptibility. Now the English word the English word of susceptibility means that the state or fact of being likely or liable to be influenced or harmed by a particular thing. So there are several factors that will make us susceptible to virus or coronavirus, any virus at all. Number one is age. There is nothing we can do about age. We must age. We must get old, either we like it or not. And we have to bear some consequences of old age. It is sad, but it's just the truth. So age is number one factor that makes us susceptible to virus. Then nutrition deficiency, there is huge connection between nutrition deficiencies, low immunity, and viruses. Then genetics. You can't do much about your genes, but you can actually do something about epigenetics by taking good food, control your sex, your stress, and environmental pollutions. Then the fourth one, immune system. The state of your immune system is very, very important, because it can affect your chances of getting virus. If your immune system is weak, you are more vulnerable or susceptible to get viruses. The microflora in our digestive system, they also fight viruses. And that microflora in our digestive system, their cells are supposed to fight bad viruses, not to enter into our system through the skin. But for years, we weaken them with chemical creams. We weaken them with perfumes and other beauty inclined therapies. So they cannot even fight viruses because they are weakened already. People who use antibiotics, steroids, or use chemotherapy usually have low immunity. So they can get viruses at easier contact. Those three things, antibiotics, steroid, chemotherapy, weakens our immune system. So it makes you more susceptible to viruses. Then chronic disease. People with chronic diseases like kidney disease, hypertension, diabetes, liver disease, and so on, are more vulnerable or susceptible to get viruses. So that's why I said, if you check yourself regularly, if you're feeling something, symptoms, you know that we're not actually there, please go to hospital, or you go to your medical practitioner, anyone you use, get yourself checked. Check yourself regularly so that you'll be able to prevent some of these chronic diseases. It's when you don't check yourself regularly that you develop those diseases and you do not know till they become chronic. So check yourself regularly, take good diets, live a good lifestyle, practice physical exercise, take vitamin D, and so on. So you'll be free from everything. Then make sure you are boosting your immune system so that you have an active immune system to fight viruses. Then stress. Stress increases our chances of getting viruses. Once the adrenal gland is not working properly, we can have high chance of getting viruses. Then to nutrition deficiency and virus. I want the, you know, the link between nutrition deficiency and virus. Soft drinks, hot dogs, meat pies, biscuits, sugar, pizza, and so on are foods that can weaken our immune system. That's just their connection. Because when you are taking this kind of foods, when you are taking junks, it weakens your immune system. They are much in cholesterol. And even cholesterol is like poison to our system. So when you have too much of cholesterol in your body, it gives ways to things like viruses to enter into our system freely without the body being able to fight them, without our white blood cell not being able to fight them. So that's why I said, eat healthy, not just eat well, eat healthy. Practice a good lifestyle so that your immunity will be very, very active, will be very, very strong. So, you know, when we take this kind of foods and our immune system is weakened, viruses become stronger. So, and when virus enters into your body, they can be, if your immune system is very, very active, it fights against them, it kills them. It kills them immediately. They don't last longer. But when your immune system is weak, that is when virus have time copy healthy cells, then spread, and your body will see it as the normal healthy cells, so it won't be able to kill them. So selenium is one important vitamin that really supports the immune system to fight viruses. In fact, people with viral infections are always deficient with selenium. If you watch people that have viral infections, they don't have selenium. They are deficient in it. So supplements of selenium are everywhere. But I prefer getting your vitamins from food sources, because most supplements nowadays are just synthetic. They are not natural. So any natural one will be very expensive, and a common man might not be able to afford it. So I prefer you get them from food sources. Viruses become more virulent in selenium and vitamin D deficiencies. In fact, many studies have proved it. So please take more vitamin D, take selenium. And it's interesting because we can afford such foods that contains vitamins, at least. For example, green leafy vegetables, especially when they are raw. So we can still get those. So it is still very good for us, at least, to take every day. So those vitamins makes white blood cells stronger and more active to perform their functions. Then fasting also helps fight viruses too, because they feed on glucose. Viruses feed on glucose. The only challenge is that we can't fast for too long. When we fast, we deprive viruses and bacteria their food, since they feed on glucose. And we can be weak when we are fasting for too long. Though we can be weak, but we can't do it for too long. So we can do it intermittently, you can use 8 hours, you can do 16 hours, you eat eight in the morning, eight at night, but don't take something that will not digest easily at night. So we can do it intermittent, can do intermittent fasting. That also helps a lot, and it also helps us to reduce cholesterol in our body. The good news is that it's not everyone with coronavirus that will die. You can recover well or not even get the virus into your system due to your overall health status. So, but if your immune system is strong and active, you might not get the virus. And let me come back to nutrition again. Vitamin C. I talked about selenium. I talked about vitamin D. Vitamin C is also very, very important. It's an antiviral nutrient. It decreases transmission period and it strengthens the immune system. It can help decrease susceptibility of getting viruses. And generally, when someone have virus, it causes extreme vitamin C deficiency, which decreases the white blood cells too. And vitamin C have the tendency to regulate T cells. The T cells are also called lymphocytes, type of leukocyte, the white blood cell. And that's an essential part of the immune system. So the T cells are one of the two primary types of lymphocytes, B cells being the second type that determines the specificity of immune response to antigens, the foreign substances in the body. So vitamin C is also necessary to make interferon. Interferon helps in killing infectious cells, which is necessary in fighting viruses. So, best foods for vitamin C are citrus fruits. One problem or challenge is we need vitamin C daily. Our body doesn't store it because it's a water-soluble vitamin. So our body doesn't store it, so we have to take vitamin C daily. And you know, when we cook our vegetables, people that put vegetables in hot water first, because there's, you know, it contains vitamin C, it contains vitamin B, and the two of them die easily when they are exposed to it. So when you put your vegetable in hot water, then before you go and cook and you expose them to it, there's nothing more in heat. The vitamin body does not store vitamin C, the vitamin B dies easily. So you don't expose them to too much of it, but make sure you take vitamin C daily. There are some other foods that contain vitamin C, like bell peppers, green vegetables, cherry, agbalumo, tangerine, orange, lemon, and so on. All these are very, very rich in vitamin C. And I told us that vitamin D is also important. It fights viruses too. Selenium also fights viruses too. Zinc is also necessary. It's very, very, very important. So please try and, you know, take all these vitamins that I've mentioned. But you can also get vitamin D from sunlight too. So vitamin D, selenium, vitamin C, zinc. Take all those ones. Improve your lifestyle and diet. And your make sure you are boosting your... There are so many natural things you can use to boost your immune system. Make sure you boost your immune system. Reduce your too much of cholesterol. And your body system will be very, very okay. So yeah, you won't be susceptible to any virus, even coronavirus. So this is where the lecture will end today. If you have any contribution, any questions for us, you can message us directly. We'll reply you as soon as possible. And if you want to speak with a doctor, you can contact us on 081-0460-7130. And if you want to visit our clinic, MB Holistic Care, situated at number 51, Abiodun Oshodiya Street, Meiran, Agbado Jaye, Lagos. So you can follow us on Instagram, also on YouTube at MB Holistic Care. So see you next time. Bye.